Natalia from Design Squad Global. We're at an engineering event in the WGBH studios in the Boston Public Library. We have to build a structure out of newspaper that can hold as many books as possible. We can only use tape, one piece of cardboard, and 10 sheets of newspaper. Our newspaper structures have to be at least 8 inches tall. We'll work in teams and we'll have 45 minutes to design and build. And then we'll see whose newspaper structure can hold the most books without collapsing. All right, let's get to work. Our plan is basically to make a box that's 8 inches high and that has a bunch of supports in it.
These are the pillars, these are the supports that connect the pillars, and then we're gonna put the book on top of the box.
How many newspapers do you think it's going to take to make one of the pillars that's supporting it?
Maybe around 2 sheets of newspaper, maybe.
We're planning out where to put our paper so we can make the strongest structure we can.
Instead of the books balancing by themselves, we're going to have our design hanging. It's kind of like a hanging basket, and the books will be here pushing down.
We did our first test, but it was a bit wobbly. The legs wouldn't hold up that well.
We definitely need to build more supports. Like, we're going to have it like a triangle shape on each side. Triangles are stronger because it's harder for them to lose their shape. That should help keep the leg from sliding.
You should roll it up and tape it and then attach it.
We're gonna have enough supports to support one thing on the top, like that. Yeah, is it's like twisting this way? Because this is like dangling out and
so we need more. That's
so we need, yeah, we need a square around the bottom.
We're putting a column in the middle to help strengthen the middle.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, our 45 minutes are up, and now it's time to test.
If we could do this again, I'd try to use a stronger beam on this side because it's kind of flimsy, it got ripped.
This is where it felt. It sort of twisted right here. It just fell over.
But I'm happy with it overall.
Next time, what I would probably do differently is first kind of make sure the columns are straight, and because these are kind of pulling into the middle, and then reinforce it because we kind of did it really quickly.
Our design is a little bit different than everybody else's. Our design used tension instead of compression. We're not going to use the table, we're going to use a stand. This is as many books as our design can hold.
Okay, we're the last group, and it's time to test.
That's one book.
In the end, our structure was able to hold 23 books.
I think the reason it was so strong is because the weight was really well distributed throughout the 4 main pillars, which were also supported by the crossbeams.
Many libraries hold engineering events like this one. Check out the events calendar at your local public library to see what activities you can participate in.
Yeah!